ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا. من يهدي الله فهو المهتد، ومن يضلله فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أرسله الله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره المشركون. أما بعد، يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه العزيز المحكم بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. ويقول الله تعالى أيضا: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: ومن أحسن قولا ممن دعا إلى الله وعمل صالحا وقال إنني من المسلمين. ولا تستوي الحسنة ولا السيئة، ادفع بالتي هي أحسن فإذا الذي بينك وبينه عداوة كأنه ولي حميم. My dear respectful brothers and sisters, in this Friday sermon, I would like to touch one topic which I feel that mostly in the discussions of the breaching, when it comes to breaching, most of the breachers, they just go through it, but most of them, they do not go, they don't go into details. So I want to look at this point in a deep research, in a kind of academic deep investigation in an academic way. That point is the one that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in His Quran: إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةٌ. Indeed, brothers, indeed, the believers are all brothers. So that point, which I'm trying to look at it today in a profound way, and I will make my base into the first two ayahs that I have recited. So to know all of that, first of all, I want to mention that we can divide brothers into two, as our common cultures. In the culture of every community, we know brother and sister, and we know that mostly brothers and sisters may be half brother and full brother. So to now, we want to know the meaning of having full brothers and sisters and half brothers and sisters. And from there, when we go back to the Quran, we can find out that half brothers and full brothers, I put them into this category, where the entire mankind, all human beings, are your brothers and sisters, and my brothers and my sisters. But again, when it comes to believers, the believers are your full brothers and sisters, and then you are also their full brother or full sister. But then, the other side, those who are the non-believers, they become non-believers, half brothers or half sisters. When you look at that, how do I say that? It is, you go back to the Quran and try to understand the meaning of the Quran by combining several verses together and then getting the meaning, to extract the meaning from those verses. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, where He is telling us that all mankind are our brothers and sisters. But the believers are full brothers and full sisters, where non-believers are half brothers and half sisters. Allah says in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ اتَّقُوا رَبَّكُمُ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُم مِّن نَفْسٍ وَاحِدًا. We always recite this verse in the opening of almost every Friday sermon, but we need to understand it deeply. Allah is talking, is addressing here to all mankind. يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ, oh people, oh mankind, oh human being, all of you, اتَّقُوا رَبَّكُمْ, fear your Lord. So fear your Lord, Allah is saying to all human beings. And then, رَبَّكُمْ, your Lord, the one who created you, sustained you, nourish you, and gives you all kinds of opportunity to survive in this world and hereafter. Then that Lord, you fear. الذي, He is the one, خَلَقَكُمْ مِن نَفْسٍ وَاحِدَةٍ, He is the one who created you from a single soul. So that Lord has created us from a single soul. That soul was one. وَخَلَقَ مِنْهَا زَوْجَهَا, and He created out of that soul her spouse. So that was one soul, and that in that time all men and women were in that soul, which was one entity. But then later on, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala divided it into two, one female and one male. And when He divided them into two, or male, from it is nature, or exactly the way it is, the kind of life of soul as it is. Then when He made those two souls, He said, خَلَقَكُم مِن نَفْسٍ وَاحِدَةٍ وَخَلَقَ مِنْهَا زَوْجَهَا وَبَثَ مِنْهُمَا رِجَالًا كَثِيرًا وَنِسَاءً. And then He spread out many, many men and women out of those two souls who were one in the beginning. They were one soul. Allah divided that soul into two, and made many, many men and women out of them. So from there, we understand that all human beings came from one origin, one soul, one individual. And from there, we should see that we are all brothers and sisters. Later on then, we divide it into two. You divide your brothers into two. Why do you divide them into two? Because human beings are created of two elements. Two elements which are the biological one, which is just physical, you see, and a spiritual one, or psychological. So human being, the contents of every person is those two, biological and spiritual or psychological. Then those two, everybody who shares you with the biological one is your brother at one step. If he or she shares with you the spiritual one, then it's your full brother and full sister. So there you understand that all human beings at the beginning, they are your brothers and sisters, but those who share the ideology, the understanding, the believing in the religion with you, then they are your full brothers and sisters. So then you have to deal with human beings as your own family, your brothers and sisters. And from there, if you want to be close to one, then you may choose the one who is your full brother and full sister. Because this person is with you both biologically and psychologically. While the other one is with you biologically. And in that sense, how do we understand all that? We can understand it in this way. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةٌ فَأَصْلِحُوا بَيْنَ أَخَوَيْكُمْ. Indeed, believers, all the believers are brothers and sisters. So make good among them. Reconcile them, bring them together. Make sure they are one. And when you have all that, then we have another word, another verse, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us, this verse Allah is telling us that all of us came from one origin, which makes that we are there and one entity and brothers and sisters. And again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us about the non-believers and the believers. And He is telling us, Allah from there is telling us that when somebody accepts Islam, in that time he or she is your full brother, which from there we can understand before they were half brother and half sister. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إنما وليكم الله ورسوله والذين آمنوا والذين آمنوا الذين يقيمون الصلاة ويؤتون الزكاة وهم راكعون ومن يتولى الله ورسوله والذين آمنوا فإن حزب الله هم الغالبون. Allah is telling us this, saying, verily, your protector and your the one who defends you and protects you, becomes your intimate friend, a real, real brother of you, of yours, is number one, the one who is your protector, your guardian, is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then is His messenger. And then it is those who believe in Allah and His messenger. When they are that, Allah is telling us who are the believers, because everybody can claim that he or she is a believer. Then we have to know who is exactly a believer. Allah is telling us in the verse, saying, الَّذِينَ يُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةَ وَيُؤْتُونَ الزَّكَاةَ وَهُمْ رَاكِعُونَ. They are none but those who establish prayer and the charity, the zakat, wahum raka'un, while they are prostrating and bowing down to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when they are, it means they pray regularly and they pay charity, the zakat. That alms they pay and their prayer and believing in one Allah and His messenger is enough to make them Muslims and real believers. And from there, you should consider them as your full brothers and sisters. It's very clear. Then, what about those who were non-believers and they were fighting against you, they were destroying you, and so on and so on. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about them also, saying, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم فإن تابوا وأقاموا الصلاة وآتوا الزكاة فإخوانكم في الدين. Indeed, if they repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala وأقاموا الصلاة and they establish the prayer وآتوا الزكاة and they pay the charity فإخوانكم في الدين, then they are indeed your brothers in the religion. So then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala here is specifying that this person, when he become a real believer, and you are a believer, you are brothers and sisters in the religion. So there you are, this brotherhood and sisterhood is based on spirituality, psychologically. But the other one is based on biological relationship. When you have that biological relationship with someone, and at the same time have this spiritual relationship with them, then what else are you looking for? That is the real brotherhood and sisterhood. And then how do you deal with them? When they are in this situation, what is the way you're gonna deal with them? It is easily, let us take an example of hadith that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, مَثَلُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ فِي تَوَادُهِمْ وَتَرَاحُمِهِمْ وَتَعَاضُفِهِمْ كَمَثَلِ الْجَسَدِ إِذَا اشْتَكَى عُضْوٌ مِنْهُ تَدَعَى لَهُ سَائِرُ الْجَسَدِ بِالسَّهْرِ وَالْحُمَى. The example, the parable of the believers at the chest, when it comes to having love, the love among themselves, adoration, being affectionate to each other, and respecting each other, and being merciful to each other, and feeling a kind of a sympathy to each other. What is that? How do you evaluate that? How can you express that? The best way to express is just like one body. You are one person, you have one body. كَمَثَلِ الْجَسَدِ like a one body. إِذَا اشْتَكَى عُضْوٌ مِنْهُ if one organ of that body and is complaining about the pain, saying you got very slight injury. You have something which is so small, or your eye and has something, or you have the smallest you can say, one finger, one nail is cut off. So then, that one, what happens? The rest of the body cannot sleep that night out of pain. إِذَا اشْتَكَى عُضْوٌ مِنْهُ تَدَاعَى لَهُ سَائِرُ الْجَسَدِ بِالسَّهْرِ وَالْحُمَى. If one organ is complaining about pain, the entire body cannot sleep and will be awake the whole night, and the entire body is complaining about that pain. So that is the best example. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave us that example, which is enough. All your brothers, your full brothers and full sisters, are the believers. If you only limit yourself to those who have same father and same mother with you, then you limit yourself into one household. And all you need is to extend your relationship, to extend your capacity to the entire world. And when you extend that to the world, then you will get all the same thing that you paid, you will get back from all the corners. So don't limit your brothers and sisters to your own household. Think out of the box. Think clearly. Why do you limit your brothers and sisters to 2 and 3 when you can get 2 or 3 billions? 2 to 3 billions, you can get them, and you want 2 or 3 individuals. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم واستغفروا الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. My dear brothers and sisters, the topic is that As you remember before, I already declared in my Friday sermons, I try my best to not to be limited to preaching, but also to teaching. Because in this world, we are very busy. We rarely get time to increase our knowledge. So I'm trying to make it both teaching and preaching to all together. And the topic is that we have billions and billions of brothers and sisters, and we should not limit them into two or three. And then how do we make them, how can we tie good relationship with the rest of the mankind, with the rest of the, our brothers in the religion? It is very easy, is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وتعاونوا على البر والتقوى ولا تعاونوا على الإثم والعدوان. Allah is very clearly telling us, you cooperate with each other in good, in doing good. Have good cooperation among yourself in order to perform good. وَلَا تَعَوَنُوا عَلَى الْإِثْمِ وَالْعُدْوَانِ. And do not help each other in aggression and sins. So it is easy that the best way is that you have good relationship with your brothers and sisters in the good things. And from there, when we are saying that, how can we continue that? How can we make a good relationship? The best way to make a good relationship is that you start it. Start it at the individual level. And then from there it grows. And it grows to farther and farther. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَعَدَ أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ بِسْمِ اللَّهِ الرَّحْمَنِ الرَّحِيمِ وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَوْلًا مِّمَّنْ دَعَا إِلَى اللَّهِ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا وَقَالَ إِنَّنِي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. Who is better in speech than the one who says, the one who calls for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, accepts the monotheism? وَقَالَ إِنَّنِي إِلَى اللَّهِ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا, and do good deeds. The one who first calls Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and then and acts better and good, the best way, being righteous, very pious person. And then after that says, وَقَالَ إِنَّنِي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ, I am one of the Muslimin, one of those who submitted themselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And one who submitted themselves to Allah peacefully while they are making peace in the world. And that, who is better than in speech? Who is better in speech than that person? It's no one. ومن دعا عمل صالحا وقال إنني من المسلمين ولا تستوي الحسنة ولا السيئة. Allah is saying the good and the bad are not equal. ادفع بالتي هي أحسن. So you rebel or answer to the bad in order to give good. Rebel to that of the best. Give them the best way. When someone gives you bad action, be it a word or action, then your response to be good. Not only good, but ahsan, better than that. Better than the good. And when you do that, هي التي أحسن فإذا الذي بينك وبينه عداوة كأنه ولي حميم. And you on there, right there, you will see that the person that who there were enmity between you and him, he will be your close friend. As there were no problem, as you had never been enemy to each other. So it is at individual level you start and putting good into everything. answering to God, making everything right, then many people will follow you. And what will happen? The one who is always the destructive person, the one who is destroying something, will see your good action. And that person, even though satanic influence is behind his action, still he or she is a human being and has the spirit in him. And then that spirit will be awakened. And then from there he will understand that there's something called good. And the person will apply the good things. So it is so simple. That person, you showed the good things by doing good only. You never told them, but they just followed your actions. And then after that, what will happen is the person who was always giving you bad attitudes, bad actions, then that person, he is still a human being. He will feel shame, and then after that will change from bad to good, and from good to better, and from better to the best. All we need is to be good at individual level, and to respond good in, at individual level. And from there, we detect all bad things, and we avoid the evil. And when I, in the beginning, I said, we have full brothers and full and half brothers. Say the full brothers are the Muslimin, the believers, the mu'minin, are your full brothers and sisters. And other people are your half brothers and half sisters. And then, who is your enemy? Your enemy is only Shaitan. Shaitan is your enemy. And then from there, how do you know that he is Shaitan? Allah tells that in many verses in the Quran, saying, إِنَّهُ عَدُوٌّ لَكُمْ. He is your enemy. أَفَتَتَّخِذُونَهُ وَذُرِّيَّتَهُ أَوْلِيَاءَ. Allah is saying, he is your enemy. He has no intention other than to destroy you. And then, are you making friends with him and his children? So Shaitan is the only enemy we have. But then, how do we see that enemy? We see people acting in a satanic way. And those people, they, as a person, they are not Shaitan, but Shaitan is using them. So we have to fight against their actions, not to hate them as an individual. So because they are your brothers, at least biologically. When I'm saying biologically, I mean the origin biology of the first soul. So then from there, you understand that the Shaitan is your enemy, and that Shaitan comes to you through the people, through everything. And so it is the satanic activities, the satanic actions that you hate, but not the person. And in altogether, when we are these brothers and sisters, what causes us to fight over nonsense, over something that's so very, very divine? And today, we see Muslims, every single day, we have over 100 people dying, not 100, 500 maximum, in average we can say. What causes all that? All we need is to understand the values, the norms, the meaning of brotherhood and sisters, and come together and be united. What shall we miss if we see each other as brothers and sisters? أقول عباد الله أوصيكم بالتقوى الله عز وجل وأحذركم لنفسي ونفسكم بمخالفة الله وعصيانه وأذكركم بأمر بدع الله بنفسه ثم بأمر بالملائكة إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله.